Last week, when it seemed as if the Phillies were going to play their scheduled games against the Yankees, I wrote a preview of the series. As you may know, the Phillies didn't actually play those games. I was going to reuse some of the content I wrote for that preview, but unfortunately, much of it is now obsolete. What I'm trying to say is that I'm the real victim here. As for the cancellations, I understand having an abundance of caution regarding a potential COVID-19 outbreak. But it isn't a good sign for the fate of the season that the team had a week's worth of games canceled without a single player testing positive for the virus. Now that the presumably healthy Phillies are ready to take the field again, let's rehash what happened the last time the Phillies played an actual game. It was an ugly affair in which, surprise, Vince Velasquez did not pitch well. Because of that dud, the Phillies lost the series, and thanks to the Marlins' laissez-faire attitude towards the virus, a week's worth of games. Perhaps the week off will help the Phillies perform better than they did against the Marlins. Based on how badly they looked in two of those games, it probably couldn't hurt. New York Yankees record, 7-1 manager, Aaron Boone. The last time they met, the Yankees visited Citizens Bank Park for three games in June 2018 and won two of the three games. The finale was won by the Phillies behind a combined shutout by Zach Eflin and Sir Anthony Dominguez. The good news is that one of those two men is expected to pitch this week. The bad news being that the other man might never pitch again. Joe goes home. The Phillies' first two opponents of the season are the two teams Joe Girardi used to manage. It's doubtful he has too many feelings either way regarding the Marlins, but I have to think that the games against the Yankees might mean a little bit more to Girardi. He managed the Yankees for 10 years, and was at the helm when the Yankees won the 2009 World Series. Now let us never speak of it again. Some say he was fired unfairly, as the 2017 Yankees would likely have made the World Series if not for the Astros' cheating ways. Others say he had grown stale, and the team was right to move on from him. Either way, he's now in charge of the Phillies, and despite what I might have said last week, I consider that to be an upgrade. Under normal circumstances, I imagine Girardi would have received a warm ovation from the Yankee Stadium fans upon his return. Maybe the stadium sound people can just pump in some additional cheers in his honor. Speaking of the fans, one benefit of not having fans in seats for these games is that we don't have to deal with the hordes of Yankee fans who would otherwise infested the stands of Citizens Bank Park. I've discussed the insufferableness of Yankees fans at length in the past, so no need to rehash.